Hello friends, welcome back to Easy Engineering by Neha Sayed. In this lecture, we are going to see a synchronous transfer mode, that is an ATM. It is most widely used technology as it transmits data at any instant of time, and it has been adopted by the ITU telecommunication standard. The data transmission, the unit for transmission of data is an cell. See, it encodes the data into small fixed size cells. Or we can also say frames, but here data unit is a cell, so we'll call it as a cell. So it will become easy to switch and share time, and it also avoid queuing delay. So it uses time division multiplexing technology for data communication. Each signal is allotted a definite amount of time. This happens when data transmission rate of media is greater than the source, and these slots are so small it appears parallel. It is a connection oriented network, and it transfers multimedia. See, it transfers multimedia means it can transmit text, it can transmit audio, it can transmit video, or it can transmit combination of them. We'll see the basic architecture of ATM. Okay, see, as you can see, firstly, we should know ATM, as I have told you, ATM is a cell switch network. The user access devices are called as endpoints, and they are connected to the user access devices are called as endpoints, and they are connected to the switches through user network interface. Okay, and where the switches are connected to the switches, they are connected via an interface which is network to network interface. See, simply whatever the endpoint is going to be connected to the switch, the interface between these two is an user to network interface. Now in the network, switch can be connected to the another switch, and the connection between them is going to be happen through network to network interface. So easily you can understand with this simple architecture. Okay, see, there are some things in the architecture of ATM that you should know. One by one we will see what are that. First thing that you should know is an virtual connection. That is virtual connection. See, connection between two endpoints is going to be accomplished through transmission path and also using virtual path and also with virtual circuit. See, what is this transmission path? What are this virtual path? What are this virtual circuit? Transmission path is a physical connection between end point and switch, or between switch and switch. Means it can be the connection between the end point and a switch. Or it can be the connection between the switch and switch, means through UNI, that is user to network interface, connection between switch and switch, means through network to network interface. Okay. See, what is a virtual path? Virtual path provides a connection between the two switches. It provides connection between two switches. Whereas virtual circuit is a cell network. See, cell networks are based on the virtual circuit, and all this cell belongs to a single message. Obviously, all this cell is going to belong to a single message, and they follow the same virtual circuit. They follow the same virtual circuit and remain in their original order until they reach the destination. Means these cells are going to be reached to their respective destination in particular order only the user has sended it. The order is not going to be shuffled. It is whatever is the sequence is going to be received by the receiver or a destination. See, for understanding the relationship between virtual path termination path, sorry, transmission path and a virtual circuit, you should see this figure. See what happened. Consider a virtual circuit. Consider virtual circuit as a lane of highway. Consider virtual path as where highway connects. Okay, consider virtual path as an highway that connects two different city. Okay, whereas consider this transmission path. See what is happening in the transmission path. It is set as an highway where directly two cities can be connected. See, simply you can understand virtual circuits. These are the lanes, okay, that are going to combine into a respective highway. Okay, these are the highway. Virtual paths are the highway. Virtual paths where it is going to be transverse. See, what is transmission path? It is the path where the two cities are going to be directly connected. Okay, so this is the relationship between transmission path, virtual path, and a virtual circuit. To route the data from one point to another point, there is need for the identifiers. Okay, see, for this purpose, hierarchical identifiers is being designed. What are that? First one is then virtual path identifier, and the next is virtual circuit identifier. It defines the specific virtual path, whereas it defines the specific virtual circuit. As the data transmission, the basic unit for the transmission of data is in cell. It is 53 byte long. We'll see the basic header for it. As you can see, it is a 53 byte long, whereas in the header, maximum part is covered by the virtual circuit identifier and a virtual path identifier. Okay, and through obviously using virtual path identifier and virtual circuit identifier, the cell is going to be travel from one end to the another end. Means the connections is going to be builded with this, with the help of this header, and the payload length is available for the actual data. So this is how cell looks like. So this is the ATM.